Hello everyone, for those of you who know me, welcome back to my channel, and for those of you who don't know me already, my name is Raul Sepina and I'm a pet portrait artist based in Belgium. In today's video I'm going to show you guys how to draw a realistic dog nose using color pencils, and I really hope you're going to find it very interesting and helpful as well. Now that everything has been said, let's get started. See you in the video, guys! For this video I'm going to use 6 colors, and the first one is a white pencil from Carandash, and I made here some fast swatches of the pencils I'm going to use, and I'm going to show you as well which ones. And so the first one is a medium flash from Faber-Castell Polychromos. They are all from Faber-Castell Polychromos, and I put here as well the number 131. The next one is a brown ochre as well from Faber-Castell Polychromos, number 182. The next one is a dark Naples ochre, number 184. A dark indigo pencil from Faber-Castell Polychromos as well, number 157. This one, and as well a black pencil, as well from Faber-Castell Polychromos, number 191. You can as well use what pencils you have, as long as they look similar with these colors here. It is important to follow those colors, because otherwise you're not going to achieve the same result as me. I'm going to zoom in a bit. So medium flash, brown ochre, dark Naples ochre, dark indigo, and black. And as well, and the white one from Carandash. And I'm going to use as well a white ink pen, and I'm going to use this one from Signo Uniball. It is a very good one. I'm going to use as well a Tombow mono eraser, as well a slice tool, a kneaded eraser, and the brush. It is a mecha brush, a very cheap one. You can use as well a blending stamp, earbuds, or even your finger or tissue paper. So that was all I'm going to use, and now I'm going to get started with the video. I started out by adding some base layers. I used my sanguine pencil and as well my dark indigo pencil for that. Then, to smoothen everything up, I used my makeup brush to make everything look a bit softer. I darkened up the nostrils a bit as well, because I like to have a bit of contrast in the beginning to know where everything is going to be placed. Then I started working on the left side of the nose by adding some shadings. I made the nostril from the left side very dark, because I like to have some contrast when I start out adding some shadows. And I'm working from light to dark, and I'm not hurrying, and I'm applying a very light pressure. It is very important not to hurry, to give yourself as much time as you need to build those layers up. With the help of my white pencil, I added some highlights to brighten up my drawing a bit. I started adding in some details using my dark indigo pencil. It is very important to add as much detail as possible to make your drawing look very realistic. By using my slice tool and the help of the white pencil, I created a very nice highlight next to the nostril. The slice tool is one of the most important tools for me when I'm drawing a pet portrait, because it is so easy to use and you can do so many things with it. I'm going to leave a link somewhere in the screen to show you how I use it. Now I started working on the whole top area of the nose. I started adding in some darker shading using my sanguine pencil, and as well to go even darker, I used my dark indigo pencil. As I said before, I'm using a very light pressure, and I'm building my layers up from light to dark. What helps to control your pressure even more is to hold your pencil as far as possible from the tip when adding very light layers. As you can see my demonstration now, I started adding in some details specifically for dog noses. Those details are made of some very small and fine circles to create even more depth and realism to the dog nose. When you start adding very fine and small details, please always make sure that the tip of your pencil is very sharp. If the tip of your pencil is going to be very dull, you won't be able to achieve this kind of details, and you may even ruin your drawing by not sharpening your pencil. I added some more highlights using my white pencil, and to make those highlights even brighter, I used my whiting pen. I moved to the bottom part of the nose and started adding some very dark shade in there by mixing my sanguine pencil with the dark indigo one. I really love the color I achieved by using those two pencils. I chose this nose, it is a golden retriever nose, and I chose it because it has so many beautiful colors. It has blues, reds and browns in it, and I think those colors make it look even more realistic, and I was really looking forward to draw them. To add even darker shadows in the bottom part of the nose, I used my black pencil and I applied a very hard pressure to darken everything up a bit. I kept adding in details with my white pencil and as well my whiting pen for some very bright highlights, and as well adding more of those very fine and small details, the round ones, to make the bottom part of the nose look realistic as well. If the dog nose from your portrait looks very plain and you don't know why, it is most probably because you don't use enough highlights and shadows. By adding a lot of contrast to the drawing, it is really boosting the realism of it, and it can make such a huge difference. When adding in details, please try not to overdo it, because by adding too many details, you can ruin your drawing and make it look very fake. What I like to do when I'm drawing dog noses is to work per sections. For example, like you said in my demonstration, I started working on the top left part and adding a lot of details there and as well of the highlights, and then I moved on the other parts, and in the end I worked on the whole bottom part of the nose. While I'm drawing, I follow very good my reference photo, and I always find some things I missed and I just put them fast on my drawing. That's why you keep seeing my hand going back and forth on the whole area instead of just working in one section. Another very important tip when you're creating very small and fine details is to hold your pencil as close as possible to the tip. By doing that, you're going to have more control over the pressure and you're going to end up by having better details. I almost finished this side of the nose and I'm going to start working on the other one. And I'm not going to explain it anymore, because I'm going to use exactly the same steps as here. So enjoy seeing me drawing the other side. Okay guys, that's all for today's video. I really hope you enjoy it and you find it very useful. If you did, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell button to be notified every time I post a new video. And as well, please like my video, it can help me a lot and I will be very grateful. Have a nice day wherever you are. Bye guys, see you in the next one.